Hello Galaxy Commanders and welcome to this video for Infinite Galaxy. We are going to try something really fun. I'm looking forward to this. I have someone on my server here who got an Artemis level 8 and I will send my Brontës against this Artemis. So to make it as even as possible, I will remove the captain. I will switch to tier 7. Therefore, I will also change my gear for that. Unfortunately, there is a small difference. My Brontës is only rank 7, his Artemis is rank 8. I don't have enough Federation credits to buy the blueprints to rank it up higher. But yeah, I think it still will be very interesting. So to get all of this as similar as possible, we limit our fleets to the same leadership amount. And I will now remove all my crew. I wish there would be a button to like remove all crew at once. But unfortunately, there is not, so we have to do this one by one. Okay, so just to give you an idea what we are against up, the captain will be removed. Gear level is level 8, so there's one purple one, one green one, it's one level below. But it's as close as we can get at the moment. In addition, we now have tier 7, 7,800 frigates inside. As said, we try to get it as close as possible to each other to have something that we can compare. We did remove the crew members as shown before. Nothing left here, no skills. We did also change
Caution.
a little bit of the gear. I put level 8 protective gear where I had 8, 1, 9 left. Weapons are changed to kinetic weapons as we now use kinetic tier 7 cruisers. Captain is also removed and we are on the way. And we'll come back as soon as we arrive and can start the battle. One last thing we have to do. We already know the core module setup, so I will have to change my core module to match this as close as possible and not have some kind of big disadvantage or advantage by using a completely different core module setup. So let's get into there. We'll have to reset it. So at this point, I want to give a special thanks to Captain Muffin. Thank you for doing this with me. Impressive that you got the Artemis already at this high rank. I wish I got an Artemis this high. As you can see, the skills are 3, 3, 2, 2, 2. So that's really nice. You get some really good bonus here. The additional 18% in speed, I'll tell you, this is crazy. We do have 200% additional armor, 50 additional armor here, 50%. So that's 250% plus a lot of shield plus 27% HP. And as said, we both limited our fleet to 7,800 leadership to make it easier to compare against each other. And yeah, one of us will have a lot of repairs, maybe both of us, depending how this fight ends. But one of us has to lose and will find all the warships in the repair bay after this. I just checked. The difference in
Slash.
rank is that my Brontës does not have the second skill on level 3 that would give around 10% additional warship attack. As I'm only using cruisers, to
True.
compensate this, what I can do is I can get either someone with kinetic weapon, or I do have, let's see, where is this guy? Cruiser output at 9.4%. So I will add Andy Perry. This will give me an additional 9.4% attack, and this will compensate the one rank difference as close as possible. So I put this crew member inside because my Prontus is one rank lower and I don't have the Federation credits to rank it up right now. I did check the packs, but I would need to buy t over 12,000 Federation credits. And that's a little bit out of my gaming budget right now. So yeah, in around close to 5 minutes, we will arrive there, and then we will see how this all works out. Okay, so here we are, both fleets ready.
Awaiting command.
We do have Artemis with TS7 frigates, and here we
Awaiting
do
command.
have the Prontus with T7 cruisers. And let's go.
Awaiting command.
Attack friendly, that is fine.
Launching.
There they go. And the beginning looks pretty good for the Prontus. We already ate away quite a big chunk of the frigates. Let's see how this looks now that the frigates have closed the gap and can fight my cruisers. That doesn't look very good for the cruisers now anymore. Pretty sure I'm going to lose this. So at the beginning we had the advantage. We cannot already start shooting while the cruisers with the cruisers because of the longer range. But then not even half of the enemy fleet we went down. I am a little bit shocked how badly we went down. I was hoping that my cruiser would give us a little better fight there. So let's take a look and go into the replay there. We should see nicely, I hope, how the fight starts. Here we do have the cruisers already shooting at all the frigates. They need to close the gap before they can start shooting at my destroyers. So this was when we were able to get a slight advantage over the enemy frigates. But as soon as they got here, they just started to decimate my cruiser fleet very, very quickly. We are equipped with kinetic weapons, so we do shoot pretty fast. I would have preferred to use laser weapons because of the high armor these cruisers have, but on the other hand, lasers would shoot much, much slower, and I'm not sure if that would really give an advantage there. And we lost it. 1.2 million left. There are a lot of frigates still flying around here, turning, doing their victory turnaround. And yeah, that's much worse than I was expecting it. I was thinking that the cruisers would perform a little bit better. We only killed around 4,000 leadership versus the Artemis killing all the 7,800 leadership of our fleet. Is it a complete fair test? Yes. I mean, we wanted to see how does the Prontus perform versus the Artemis, I know there is also legendary flagship, hopefully sometime available, the Cyclops. The Cyclops will perform better, no question. The skills will be higher. I mean, we always see this. Having legendary skills gives you a much, much bigger, much, much higher bonus. So I would say, sure, the Brontës should perform worse as it is not a legendary flagship. You have to think about this. Captain Muffin ranked up the Artemis to rank 8, while I still struggle here at rank 7 with my epic flagship. So I'm glad to be able to show that it is absolutely worth investing in the legendary flagships, that the Artemis is working really great. All these frigates, they just decimated my cruisers quickly, even with the skill from the Prontus that increases the damage output from cruisers versus frigates. No chance to go through there. So I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. I was really, really curious, looking forward to get
Repair
this.
ships.
18 hours repair, 1 million. That's what you get from doing this kind of stuff, trying things out. I'll also have to repair my
Flagship.
Prontus. It says damaged, it looks like around 50. Oh no, it's better. So not so bad, just an hour repair time here. And yeah, if you have something else you would like to get tested, let me know. Let's talk about this in Discord. Let's try to find someone with a flagship in the right rank available that we can bet them up, one flagship versus another, and see how they do perform. And just to say it or point it out again, this also confirms all the data I gathered and shared with you in the flagship tier list. As you remember, the Artemis is a higher tier compared to the Prontus, and we just saw it why it is like this. Okay, hope you liked the video. Hit the subscribe button if you didn't do it yet. Give it a like, join us on Discord, and then I'll see you all on the next video again.